Just the three strong words of song, the century from nature. Why Christmas? Why did Jesus come here on the earth? Why Jesus was born in the earth? In the beginning, God created man in his own image to have fellowship with God. God created man for his own pleasure and glory. And they used to live together in relationship until man disobeyed and sinned against God. Then God's wrath came upon all human race and people became cursed and rebelled against God. Then in turn, because of our sin, God's patience and His glory left from people, and God no longer lived with human beings. People started to live on their own and at their own ways. Then people became lawless, selfish, impure, sinful, and adulterous. Godly ways was totally forsaken, and God had to destroy this world once in the water and started a new life. A new human race with Noah was the only one righteous person left in the world at that time, and we all know that God wants us to be righteous, pure, holy, selfless, sinless persons who walks with God and live with God for eternal. And there was a man whose name was Enoch. He walked with God all days of his life, and God was so pleased with him that he took him to heaven alive. And we know that too. And this is the reason Jesus has come to this earth, to enable us to walk with God here in the earth and take us to heaven after this life. Jesus came to live among us. He came so that we can live with God forever. Amen. Jesus came not because we can have lavish lifestyle like celebrity with lots of money, lots of physical pleasure, physical satisfactions, name and fame, lots of power and influence like politicians have, lots of houses, cars like businessmen have, lots of slaves and workers like Richmond King. Jesus came not this, any of these reasons. Jesus didn't come for any of this reason. He came so that we can have life in God. And we all have sinned and have fallen away from God. Because of our sins, there is no connection. There was no connection between God and man. And people were so sinful that either God had to destroy this world and his creations, or send his one and only Son to save the world, to save the human race. And you know that God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son. So therefore, Jesus had to come to this earth to reconnect us with the God, to restore our relationship with God. And Jesus shed his blood and gave his life on the cross so that we may overcome the death. We may overcome the death that was the penalty of our sin and live our life in holy, pure, sinless and righteous manner. And Jesus came for that. And this was the good news to all human race. When Jesus was born, this was the good news the angel brought to the shepherd that caused great joy for all the people at that time. This was the good news of Jesus' birth. It causes the great joy among all people. But my question is, have this good news of Jesus' birth brought good news to you and to me as well? To Christians of this world, has this good news brought good news to us? This is my question. Can you tell the whole world proudly that on this Christmas day, that we can tell that on this Christmas day, Jesus was born? And can you tell the whole world proudly on this Christmas day that I have an extremely good news for you, my friend, my family, my relatives, my neighbor? I have extremely good news for you. Can we tell that proudly? And that good news is Jesus Christ. Can we tell that proudly? With a great joy. Can we tell this to others with a great joy today? And proudly, your answer could be no. And my answer as well, no. And then if the answer is no, then we have really not received the good news. We haven't really received Jesus Christ and believed in him. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. God has given us eternal life. And this life is in his Son, Jesus Christ. 1 John 5:1. Matthew 2:10. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. Are we overjoyed today? Are we overjoyed? And again, answer will be no. Why? My fellow Christians, friends, though we know Jesus, we are still pursuing the worldly richness and desire. We are still pursuing the worldly richness and desire, though we know Jesus Christ. Our hope, our love, and happiness is in worldly things such as money, promotion, better life. We desire and we are fighting for the worldly things like our career, name, fame, promotions, money, etc. And people are dying not because of poverty, lack of education, food or clean water. I tell you this. People are dying not because of poverty, not because of lack of money or lack of education or lack of food or lack of clean water. But because of sin, because of the immorality that is happening in this world, because of the adultery that is happening, that is taking place day by day in this world, people are dying because of that sin. When we get married, we are supposed to be complete and be fulfilled in each other. As Bible says, wife is the rib of husband, and when they come together, becomes complete. We marry not because of our supposed talent, beauty, wealth, or any other reason, but we marry because he or she is the one of your missing part. And you marry to spend happily the rest of your life with each other. But what happens is we don't simply become happy by the fact that he or she is your wife or husband, but we look for more. The worldly desire and demands. We look at others and we demand the same from our spouse. In the same way, there was emptiness and void in our heart, even since we separated from the God. Because of our sin, we were separated from the God, and there was emptiness and void in our heart, in every heart. And when we believe in Jesus Christ, he comes to live in us, and we will be complete and fulfilled in God. Ever since good news happened to us, for Jesus is born in our life, we will start to live in God and God in us. And this relationship will be for eternal. But after receiving Jesus Christ too, we are pursuing for worldly things. We are still sinning, and we are still passions of our sin. We are still sick of our sin. We are not healed. We desire for more of this worldly pleasure and richness than of the heaven. Once Jesus has broken the chains, once Jesus has washed the sin, we ought to be healed, restored, connected to God. Our pride, our pleasure, our happiness should have been on our purity, on our holiness, on our righteousness, on our sinless life. But it hasn't happened. Our faith should have become more stronger day by day in God. After receiving Jesus Christ, our faith should have become stronger day by day. And our hopes should have centered on the things above and the things to come. And our love should have been first for God and second for those who are in need. For mankind to live, Jesus has to be born in every heart and in every mind. Otherwise, all will die of the same. If Christmas has come to us, my friend, my fellow Christians, friend, if Christmas has come to us, if good news has come to us, Jesus will be born in us, and we will be healed, and our peace, our happiness, our fulfillment, and completeness will be His. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of the God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. The true life that gives life to everyone has come into this world. His name is above every name, and at that name every knee should bow in heaven and earth and under the earth. Let's spread the good news, and all who will hear it will be amazed at what Jesus has done to us. Let's treasure up all these things which will ponder in our heart. Let's glorify and praise God for all the things he has done and given. Rejoice greatly, sons and daughters of the God. Rejoice greatly, sons and daughters of the God. Shout, military Jhunda. See, your king comes to us, righteous and victorious, on the white horse, in the cloud, with the great power and glory. And the star will fall from the sky. The star will come from the sky, and the power of the heaven will be shaken. Then every man will see every man will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. And he will send out the angel to gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of the heaven. This is Christmas. And happy Christmas, everyone. Thank you.
हामी त्यही उहाँको जन्मको उत्सवबाट मनाइरहेका छौँ. हुन्छ, अब गर्दाखेरि अब हामी केक कटिङ सेरेमोनीमा हामी जानेछौँ. Simpson Valley, Pinpani. I'm a Tali Portagan Valley. Don't have a next follow up, sir. Mwah. Romero. Mrs. Moreno, please, already, I do, please. Only I'm like, guitar or side camera, and then you say, Rakesh, why like, for you, I'm not going to go over there, sir. Rakesh, why like, don't go on the chance to I'm like, one is one of them, Gita and Jay, practice for example, I'm a 4-6 darling. Gito, both say, कति राम्रो सृष्टि भएर हिमाल पहाड तराई छ यो यो गीत चाहिँ उता नेपाल हाम्रो मण्डली को हाम्रो दाजुभाइहरुले गाउनु भएको धेरै अघि मसँग सिडी पनि अलिकति त्यो तपाईहरु बाँड्नु भनेको त्यो सायद युकेमा छोडेर
Thank you. Yeah. Hello. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Hello. Thank you. is it Jhunda ka chadke banana ka chadke bhai jango ani boini
the remaining